research is kind of unusual because it's at the intersection of GIS, or geographic information systems, and health. So we draw on two different, entirely different traditions in terms of research methodologies, epistemology, etc. And but what it's allowed me to do is finger into all sorts of areas of health research. And right now I'm working on a global health project in which we're developing an injury surveillance system in South Africa at a hospital in Cape Town. And the interesting thing is that injury is, you know, the biggest cause of loss of life, loss of functional daily lives in Africa, but yet so little attention is paid to it. In fact, a lot more attention is paid to AIDS, malaria, TB. But if you take AIDS, malaria, and TB combined, they account for fewer deaths every year than injury. And so our philosophy is that the key to injury control or injury reduction is simply to understand where it occurs and what causes it. So the first thing we're trying to do is implement injury surveillance, which is really just accounting for, just documenting every injury that comes into the hospital and where it occurred. And my unique slant is that I look at health from a spatial perspective. So I look at where things occur in space, because if we know where injuries occur, then we can target prevention efforts that aren't sort of across the board and amorphous, but they're specific to the actual geographical locale. So that's one of the areas I'm really interested in. Another area that I'm really interested in is understanding the relationship between socioeconomic status and health. And one of the things that we know is that if your socioeconomic status, so your combined income, education, etc., is lower relative to the people around you, then your health outcomes are going to be worse across the board, whether it's as a result of your health outcome as a result of severe injury or cancer or TB or diabetes, etc. Socioeconomic deprivation is a great indicator for how well you're going to do and how well you're going to live. So I'm interested in understanding, for various diseases and actually multiple comorbidities, why people do well in some places and don't do as well in other places. And we often find it has to do with socioeconomic status, but we're also starting to look at the effect of the environment, the actual physical or built urban environment, on people's health.